Oke, bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Baik, teman-teman, selamat datang kembali pada pertemuan kelas TOEFL practice ya. Baik, dengan kemarin kita sudah membahas tenses, yaitu yang berhubungan masa lampau. Oke. Berarti yang saat ini yang belum adalah tinggal yang perfect tenses ya. Dan begitu juga dengan nah, kaitannya nanti ini perfect tenses itu dengan if clause ya, atau clauses ya. Jadi sentence, clause, and paragraph. Oke. Okay. Jadi yang pertama kita talk about tenses dulu ya, atau sentence tenses in a sentence ya, and then after that is clause. Habis clause baru kita masuk ke yaitu paragraph. Oke. Okay. Baik, tes. Oke, ini mic-nya agak ini ya, apa kurang bersahabat. Oke, kita akan mulai. Jadi mohon maaf ini saya pakai gambar begini karena kondisi badan saya kurang sehat juga ya, teman-teman. Ya, kemarin itu satu minggu saya pulang malam terus untuk membantu teman-teman dosen yang ada di Unisri untuk memenuhi kebutuhan nilai bahasa Inggrisnya. Jadi mau nggak mau saya harus bergadang di sana dan pulang malam. Oke. Okay. Anyhow, kita akan mulai ya. Pertama saya akan buka dulu tentang apa yang akan kita bahas, yaitu tentang grammar ya. Jadi ini masalah grammar ini paling penting ya. Maksud saya bukan yang lain nggak penting, yang lain juga penting ya, kayak listening, reading ya, itu juga penting semua, tapi grammar ini salah satu yang membutuhkan kesemua aspek ya. Jadi ada aspek readingnya, ada aspek listeningnya ya. Jadi yang kemarin kita sudah bahas past time ya, oke, present time juga kita sudah bahas ya. Ini saya ambil dari Grammar Betty yang levelnya intermediate ya. Jadi saya anggap bahwa mohon maaf sebentar. Halo? Halo? Udah, ini udah aku lagi bikin video, aku lagi bikin video. Lagi nang ini? Belum. Nabunda kemana ini? Test 1, 2. Oke, mohon maaf tadi ada ke masalah teknis. Oke, kita akan kembali ke anunya kita ya. Jadi ini levelnya ada udah intermediate ya. Dan ada beberapa topik yang nanti kita langsung bahas secara tidak semuanya ya, yang saya pilih nanti hanya yang berhubungan aja, yaitu kayak adjective clause ya, terus ada kayak noun and pronoun, and then we have passive and comparison. Okay. Jadi kita masuk ke yang pertama, present perfect. Ya, bukan pertama ya, udah ke sekian ya. Kita masuk ke present perfect atau tenses. Jadi tenses ini yang terakhir ya. Ini adalah tenses yang terakhir, yaitu perfect tenses. Karena berhubungan dengan sentence ya, atau kalimat yang relasinya tentang waktu. Oke. Ini saya akan buka ini. Oke, masih menunggu apa yang terjadi. Oh ya, udah. Oke, baik. Jadi kita masuk ke the present perfect and past perfect ya, atau perfect tenses. Oke. Jadi yang kemarin kayaknya sudah sekilas balik ya, tapi saya akan review lagi tentang perfect tenses. Oke. So review and preview ya. Present and past. Oke, kita memahami dulu apa itu present and past ya. So Jenna loves her dog. His name is Max, yeah. And then Jenna's grandfather gave Max to her. Her grandfather found him at an animal shelter. Jenna takes very good care of her dog. He is a great dog. Oke, okay. Jadi dalam satu kalimat atau dalam satu paragraf ya, itu kita bisa membuat suatu cerita ya, di mana cerita itu bisa menggabungkan antara present dan past ya, dan juga there's also a chance that perfect tenses juga bisa berhubungan dengan present and past also. So Jenna loves her dog. Ini adalah present. Ya, yeah. His name is Max. Ya, yeah, ini adalah present. Jadi ini dari kalimat yang pertama, ada dua kalimat yang pertama ini menjelaskan tentang keadaan sekarang. Yeah. And then the second sentence, Jenna's grandfather gave Max to her. Jadi ini menceritakan bahwa kakeknya itu telah memberikan anjing yang bernama Max itu kepada Jenna. Okay. Her grandfather found him at an animal shelter. Nah, ini menceritakan bahwa dulunya itu Max itu ada di animal shelter dan dibeli atau dipungut oleh kakeknya Jenna. Jenna takes good care of her dog. He is a great dog. Nah, ini menceritakan sekarang juga. Saat ini Jenna mengurus si Max dengan baik, dan si Max ini adalah juga anjing yang baik. Oke, okay, let's practice past participle. Ya, past participle ini yang bentuk ketiga ya. Jadi yang bentuk pertama present, bentuk yang kedua simple past, dan bentuk yang ketiga adalah past participle. Ada juga yang namanya adalah present participle. Nah, present participle itu yang berhubungan dengan inform ya. Jadi teman-teman, kalau ada bentuk perintah di mana kita harus membentuk kalimat dalam bentuk present participle, nah present participle itu adalah inform. She has forgotten his name. And then simple form, past simple, and then past participle. Okay, finish, stop, wait, see, make, and put. Wait a bit. Give me 1 second. Okay, baik. Mohon maaf. Dari bentuk ini ya ada regular and irregular. Okay. Jadi teman-teman yang harus dipahami bahwa in English we have to remember a certain verb. Ya, jadi dalam bahasa Inggris itu kita harus benar-benar memahami atau menghafal beberapa kata dalam bentuk verbnya ini, ada regular and irregular form ya. Regular itu di mana kata dasarnya itu tidak berubah, itu namanya regular, kata dasar tidak berubah, hanya ditambahkan ed aja. Oke. Nah, seperti ini ya. Finish, finished, finished, finished. Stop, stopped, stopped, stopped. Waited, sorry, wait, waited, waited. Okay, so here kata dasarnya adalah finish. Dan bentuk simple past and past participle itu tidak berubah ya. Jadi ada kata finish, tetap menggunakan kata finish. Ada kata stop, tetap menggunakan juga kata stop. Dan begitu pun juga ada kata wait, tetap menggunakan kata wait, yaitu waited ya. Lain halnya dengan irregular verb ya, we have see, make, and put. Nah, kalau irregular verb ini dia adalah kata kerja yang tidak beraturan. Yang tidak beraturan itu maksudnya apa? Dari kata dasar hingga kata kedua dan ketiga ya, simple past dan past participle itu terkadang berubah-berubah ya. Terkadang berubah-berubah, tidak semuanya berubah-berubah, tapi terkadang berubah-berubah. Oke, okay, we have see. Oke, okay, we have see, so seen, make, made, made, put, put, put. Oke. Okay. Ya. Yeah. Jadi ada yang berubah dari awal sampai akhir, ada pun yang dari awal berubah, dua dan ketiga tetap sama ya. Ada juga yang dari awal dan kedua dan ketiga tetap sama, yaitu put-put-putnya. Ada put-put-put, set-set-set ya. And then we have apa lagi ya? Many, I forgot ya. There's many, I can't remember, really remember all of them ya. Ada put-put-put, set-set-set. Terus there are apa ya, I forgot. Okay, then we have the simple form. Stop, stopped, go, went, take, took, right, road. Oh, practice. Okay, okay, okay. Let's practice here. Okay, stop, stop, stop. Yeah, ini pakai ed. Okay. And then nggak dikunci. Wait, wait. Sebentar. Kita sampai practice ini ya. Okay, stop, 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 stopped, and then go, went, gone, take, took, taken, and the right road, written. Okay. And then the form of present perfect. Nah, ini yang rumusnya ya. Jadi teman-teman harus benar-benar memahami atau harus ingat-ingat. Dalam bahasa Inggris, rumusnya itu kalau teman-teman harus cinta matematika, nah ini berkaitan dengan rumus, bahasa Inggris juga ada rumus ya. So he has finished his work. I have worked very hard this year. The student have worked hard. Alex has worked very hard. So setiap kalimat positif dan positif statement itu harus ada kata kerja bantu atau auxiliary verb-nya, yaitu have dan has ya. Dimana have itu penggunaannya adalah I, you, we, they, have ya. And then he, she, it itu pertanyaannya adalah has. Okay.
Dan kata kerja berikutnya adalah kata kerja asli, yaitu bentuk yang ketiga. So, I, subject, have, to be, atau auxiliary verb. And then verb 3-nya, work. Okay. Work, I have worked very hard this year. The students have worked hard. Alex has worked very hard. Okay, they have, and then go home. Gone home. Okay, pronunciation have, itu disingkat kayak gini. He's gone home. Nah, ini singkatan dari has. Ya, tapi hati-hati, ini bisa juga teman-teman bisa keliru ya, atau mistaken by she is, he is. Ya. Nah, di mana kita tahu apa ini has atau is? Ya, kalau dianya pakainya is, maka kata kerja berikutnya itu dalam bentuk inform ya. She is going home. Itu adalah she is. She's going home. Itu she is. Tapi kalau sini, she's gone home. Nah, ini adalah verb 3. Verbnya adalah ketiga dari go, went, gone. Ya. Jadi verb ketiganya adalah gone. Otomatis ini adalah he atau she has. It's been hot all week. Okay, I have not gone home yet. Fatima has not gone home. Nah, negatif, of course, negatif tinggal kasih kata not ya, teman-teman. It's very simple. Okay, and then negative contraction haven't. Okay, and then hasn't. Okay, the form of present perfect. Have you read the report? Has Mercy gone home? How long have you worked there? Okay, good question. Have, has, subject plus past participle. Have you read all of his article? Have you read all this of this article? No, I haven't. I have only read a few pages. Short answer. Have, although I haven't. Has Kyung finished her homework? Yes, she has. She did it after school. Short answer, has. She has. Although she hasn't. Okay, present perfect. You touch ever. Bentuk pertanyaannya adalah, have you ever touched a snake? Touch never. No, I have never touched a snake. Present perfect, shark, have Justin ever seen a shark? Has Justin ever seen a shark? Yes, he has. He saw one near Cape Town, South Africa. Okay, and then we have Taylor has taken his first step. Zoe hasn't walked by herself yet. The meaning of present perfect. Present perfect ini yang untuk membedakan tenses ini dengan tenses-tenses yang lain adalah dia tidak menyertakan keterangan waktu. Adverb of time itu tidak ada dalam bentuk present perfect. Ya. Oke, okay, jadi ini membedakan antara tenses simple present, simple past, ya. And then future, okay. Nah, kalau present perfect atau perfect tenses ya, present maupun past perfect, itu tidak ada keterangan waktunya. So, present perfect meaning one, something happened before now at an unspecified time. Jadi sesuatu yang terjadi sebelum sekarang di mana tidak ada keterangan waktunya, unspecified time. Taylor has already taken his first step. Kapan? Nggak tahu, tapi kita tahu bahwa he has already taken his first step. Zoe hasn't walked by herself yet. Okay. And then have you ever seen Zoe crawl? okay, occur before now or something in the past. Ya, jadi terjadi sebelum sekarang atau sesuatu yang di waktu lampau. Ya, walaupun ini terjadi di waktu lampau, tapi kita tidak boleh menggunakan adverb of time. Ya, jadi we don't put present perfect, yaitu subject have, has, atau verb 3, dan juga ada keterangan waktu, itu tidak boleh. Ya, contohnya seperti ini, Joey hasn't walked by herself yesterday, atau Joey hasn't walked by herself yet last week. Nah, itu juga nggak boleh. Ya. Okay, meaning Taylor has already taken his first step. Yeah, so a time from now and before now. Yeah, jadi inilah keterangan waktu yang before now. Okay, time-nya nggak ada. Nah, makanya itu without unspecified time. Mary has painted portrait many times. Student have painted portrait twice. Activity repeated before now unspecified past time. Mary has painted portrait many times. Her student have painted portrait twice. So a time where now and before now. Ya, jadi before now itu bisa berkali-kali gitu, tapi nggak tahu kapan. Okay, meaning to a situation began in the past and continue to the present. Nah, ini yang kedua. Penggunaan dari present perfect tenses ya adalah kita bisa mengetahui kejadian waktu lampau sampai sekarang dengan ada bukti-bukti tertentu atau ada petunjuk-petunjuk tertentu. Ya, contohnya seperti ini. I have written to John so he knows what's happening now. Yeah, I have written to John so he knows what happening now. Ya, jadi kejadian waktu lampau, I have written to John. Okay, dan pada bersamaan juga bahwa dengan keterangan waktu dengan keterangan surat itu John mengetahui situasi sekarang, ya. Atau seperti ini, second example is I have made a cake, would you like some? Kejadian in the past yaitu saya membuat kue, I have made a cake. Dan kejadian sekarang yaitu saya menawarkan kue ini kepada kalian atau pada teman-teman. Ya, jadi penggunaan dari atau penggabungan antara past dan present itu kita menggunakan dalam bentuk present perfect. I have made a cake. Would you like some? Ya, I have made a cake. Okay, I have made a cake. Jadi I have itu adalah present perfect, ya. Di mana in the past saya membuat kue. And then in the present time now I'm offering you the cake. Jadi kalimatnya adalah would you like some? I have made a cake, would you like some? Okay, we have been working since 8 o'clock. I have played the violin for 6 years. I learned to play 6 years ago and I still play it. Okay, present perfect. Itu ada kata since and for, ya. Membedakannya apa? Since itu adalah awal kejadian. Ya, I've been working since 8 o'clock. Ya, awalnya dari jam 8 saya telah bekerja. But for itu adalah durasi. Okay, so I have played the violin for 6 years. Okay, I learned to play 6 years ago and I'm still playing. Okay, meaning 2. I've been working since 8 o'clock. Kyung has already taken the test. Oh, let's practice. Okay, so meaning 2, I have been working since 8 o'clock. Okay.
Jadi ini dari waktu lampau hingga ke sekarang itu adalah awal. Since adalah awal mulanya. Okay. Kyung has already taken the test. Which one is this one? Something happened before now at another time. Okay, let's see. It's the one, the first one. Okay, something happened before now and another time. I've been studying since 8 a.m. That's apa bawah? Okay, bawah. Yes, at the bottom. And then Rosa has been to Italy 3 times. Okay, which one is this? Meaning one or meaning two? Okay, meaning one. Okay. There's no specific time, yeah. But this one, situation begin in the past and continues to the present. Nah, ini dia continue. Okay, I had an angel fish when I was a child. I have had many other fish since then. Jadi simple past versus present perfect. Okay. I had an angel fish for the when I was a child. Jadi saat kecil saya memiliki apa? Ikan. Dan sekarang I have had many other fish since then. Dan sekarang saya memiliki banyak beragam ikan. Ya, oke. Saya telah memiliki banyak beragam ikan dibandingkan saya waktu dulu ya. Okay, simple past, they completed the game at 4. Present perfect, they have already completed the games. Okay, lihat perbedaannya dari simple past dan present perfect ya. Present perfect itu walaupun menceritakan kejadian waktu lampau, tapi ada kaitannya dengan in the present, ya. Yeah. They have already completed the game. Ada keterangan waktunya, ya. Yeah, 4 o'clock, okay. Tapi ini unspecified time, tidak ada keterangan waktunya atau kita tidak tahu kapan the game finish, ya. Yeah. It just give you explanation that it already had finished. I was in Nigeria when I was 5 years old. I have been to Nigeria 3 times. Ya, nah, saya pernah ada di Nigeria selama atau ketika saya masih umur 5 tahun. Tapi di sini hanya menerangkan bahwa ya saya pernah ke Nigeria. Ya, kapannya dia tidak perlu dikasih tahu. But I have been there. Ya, saya pernah mengunjungi. Okay. Ada specific time and unspecified time. So simple past, Jack camped in France for 9 days. Ellie has been camping for 9 days. Ellie has been camping since last Monday. Okay, for activity began and ended in the past, itu kita pakainya for. Then kalau present perfect, for and since ini adalah activity began and continues. Okay, let's practice here. Specific time and unspecified time. We have been in Tokyo many times. Okay, many times means unspecified. So it's present perfect. Okay, we wait for the answer first.
Okay, kita lanjut. So we have here, Barry has never been to Tokyo. Okay, unspecified time. Never is unspecified time. Present perfect. Jiro went to Tokyo last month. Ada keterangan waktu? Yes, last month, so specified. Simple past. Okay, we're using since and for. I have been here since 6 a.m. I have worked here since noon. I have worked here since Wednesday. I have worked here since April. I have worked here since 2016. I have worked here since May 9, 2007. I have worked here since yesterday. I have worked here since last week. Okay, since it means specific point in time. Okay. Correct. I have studied English since 2007. I have used a computer since 2007. Incorrect. I am studying English since 2009. Ini salah ya. Jadi penggunaan since and for itu hanya ada di dalam kalimat tense perfect. Okay, kalimat perfect. Baik itu present perfect atau past perfect itu adanya adalah since and for ya. Present perfect plus since. Okay. Present progressive do not use since. Incorrect. Okay, I study English since 2009. Ini juga present perfect pakainya since, but simple present cannot use since ya. Don't use since. Okay, simple past juga not use. Okay. The main clause and since clause. Nah, ini ya. Kita sudah masuk ke bagian clause atau perkenalan dari bagian clause. I have known her since I was 15. Jim has played many sports since he tried soccer. Since time clause. Okay, I've worked here for 50 minutes. I've worked here for 5 hours. I work here for 10 hours, 10 days. I've worked here for about 6 weeks. Mashallah. I've worked here. I've worked here for almost 2 months. I have worked here for many years. I have worked here for a long time. For, it means the length of time, ya. Jangka waktu. Tapi kalau since, ada awal mula, itu since, ya. I have worked here for 12 years. I got a job here 12 years ago and I still have it. I played sports for 15 years. Am I too busy now? Okay, and then present perfect. For is the length of time, ya. For itu adalah keterangan waktu, jangka waktunya. Okay, from the past to the present. Simple past, only past. Yeah, I played sport for 15 years. Okay. Jadi kalau untuk for ini boleh digunakan dalam tenses-tenses yang lain. Okay, let's practice. 3 hours, she was 6. Mary has been playing the piano since she was 6. Mary has been playing the piano for 3 hours. Gerardo has studied English since he started school. Alejandro has studied English for 15 years. I have driven a taxi
I have driven a taxi since. My uncle has driven a taxi for 30 years. Okay, Dean has been working for 10 hours. Dean has been working since 6 o'clock. She has been working for 10 hours. Okay, statement have, has, and been. How long has he been working? Okay. Bentuknya adalah has she been working, atau ada kalau ada kata WH ya, dan 1H itu lebih dulu. Okay. Mary is playing the piano right now. Present progressive, in progress right now, during of a time not mentioned. Mary has been playing the piano right now. Itu sudah salah ya. Jadi terkadang present progressive itu apa, duration of time is not mentioned. In progress right now, Mary is playing the piano. Mary is in progress right now. Mary has been playing since noon. Mary has been playing for an hour. Okay, present progressive. Began in past, in process right now, in time, sorry, time express, present perfect progressive. You cannot say Mary is playing the piano soon. Okay, since soon. It belongs to Amy. It belongs to Amy. She has owned it for 1 month. She has been owning it for 1 month. Okay, no action verb. Okay, jadi nggak ada kata belong atau has been ya. Okay, present progressive atau present perfect progressive. My sister is using the phone. She has used it for 3 hours. She has been using it for 3 hours. Her parents are dancing. Her parents are dancing. They together for over 30 years. They have been dancing together for over 30 years. Where are you going this summer, for the summer holiday? I am going to the beach. Okay, sorry. Stop frozen. I've already fed the dog. Already, yeah. We are using already, yet, still, and anymore. I fed the dog 30 minutes ago. I already fed the dog. It happened before now. Position in my sentence. Yet, I usually feed the dog, but I haven't fed him yet. No. Not happened before now, but position end of the sentence. I fed the dog 30 minutes ago, so he is still hungry, he still wants to eat. Okay, ini ada kata yet, still, And the following object and still, sorry, astaghfirullahaladzim. I fed the dog 30 minutes ago. He's still hungry. He still wants to eat. I like classical movie when I was in college. I still like them. It hasn't rained all the week. It still isn't raining. Okay, situation continues to exist. Still. Anymore. I used to be a teacher, but I retired. I don't work anymore. Does not continue position end of the sentence. Okay, affirmative sentence. I already fed the dog. I haven't fed him yet. I don't know. I don't work anymore. Okay. Okay, let's practice here. So, sorry. Whoa. Astaghfirullahaladzim. Still, itu adalah affirmative or negative sentence, bisa digunakan. Yet and anymore adalah ini bentuk kalimat negatif. And then, already. I already, ini adalah kalimat persetujuan affirmative. She doesn't have any money. She already spent it all. I did some homework, but I still have to do more. We used to be friends, but we had an argument. We don't like each other. We used to be friends, but we had a lot of arguments, so okay, so we don't like each other anymore. When they arrived at the store, it had already closed. When they arrived at the store, it had already closed. People, events in the past, first event, last thing. The store had already closed when I arrived. Okay, from had plus past participle. It's closed. Okay. What the whole hobby is? Sorry, already closed when they arrived. Form had past participle. It closed. She'd gone home. He'd gone home. They'd gone home. We'd gone home. You'd gone home. Yeah, contraction. Ingat, kalau akhirannya adalah D atau S, ya, kita lihat kalimat berikutnya, yaitu the third tenses, ya, third form. Close, have gone, gone home, gone home, gone, gone, gone. Okay, present perfect. Kejadian in the past, ada buktinya hingga sekarang. Yeah, I'm not cooking now. I've already ordered pizza. Occurred before now and unexpected time. I'm not cooking now. I've already ordered pizza. Occurred before now and as by the time. Past perfect before noon and noon. I was not cooking at noon. I had already ordered pizza. Okay, occurred before another time in the past. Past progressive. Began. A particular time in the past.
The mission had arrived when I made home. The pizza had arrived when he came home. Yeah, there's no related in the future. Yeah, still and in the past. I had already gone to bed when it started snowing. It started snowing. Yeah, it started snowing. I went to bed first. Okay. And then I tried to go shopping, but the store had closed. So which one did the action go first? The action go first is I tried to go shopping, but the store had closed. I tried to go shopping. Oh, the store closed first. And then I tried to go shopping. A friend called to suggest a good movie. She had seen it last Friday. The friend saw a good movie that will be first, and then a friend called second. Okay. Still have one more, yeah? Okay, we still have how many? 49 minutes. Okay, kita masuk ke bagian noun and pronoun. Okay. Kita masuk ke noun and pronoun here. Oke, kita masuk ke bagian ini, ya. Pronunciation of final S and ES, noun and pronoun, plural form of noun, subject verb, and objects, object of preposition, preposition of time. Then we have word order, place and time, subject verb agreement, using adjective to describe noun, using noun as adjective. Sampai 9 aja ya. Okay, we have cat, cats. One cat, two cats. Eats, tats, bikes. S as in bus, voiceless sound. S as in bus, voiceless sound. Example TPK. K reads jars, tolls, pause. Z as in buzz, voice sound. Voice sound, ada dengaran suara apa, getarannya, yaitu pakai D, R, L, M, B. Okay, all vowel sounds. So, setiap kata apa, aktif, pasif ya. Wish, wishes, catch, catches, guess, guesses, slide, slices, wage, wages. Then we have judge, judges. Okay, add a simple S or ES pronouns. Add a syllable S or ES pronoun as after ch, zg. Okay, we have practice. Practice cupcakes. Equal cupcakes. S. Watches. Watches. S. Cars. Cars. Z. One potato. Six potatoes. One dream. Two dreams. One boat. Two boat. One shoe, two shoes, was popular at S. Yeah, I think so. One wish, two wishes. One latch, two latches. One glass, two glasses. One mix, two mixes. It's simple. We have sehat, sehat. One boy, two boys, one ray, two rays, one life, two lives, one elf, two elves. Okay, and in F A or F becomes oofs. Exception, beliefs, chief, roots, cloth, and cliff. Ending zero, sometimes zero S. Sometimes OS. Potato, tomato, and area in go. Ooh, okay, let's practice. One goat, two goats, one ape, two many apes. One stitch, many stitches. Okay, kita masuk ke order sekarang ya, bagian letak-letaknya. Okay, we have a subject is a noun. A subject is a noun. Ya, setiap kata benda itu adalah noun. Subject bird and fish, and then verbnya adalah fly and swim. A sentence has subject and a verb. Jadi dalam bahasa Inggris, satu kalimat itu terdiri dari dua elemen, yaitu subject, noun, ya, and then verb, yaitu kata kerja sendiri. Ring have wings, fish have gills. And this one is object. The order of a verb is a noun. Okay, let's practice. Gina studies Italian. Which one is Gina? Our subject is Gina. Okay. What is the verb? Italy. And then book. Okay. Zebra have stripes. zebra, verbnya adalah have, and then objectnya adalah stripes. Horses love apples. Subjeknya apa ini? Horses love and they are wearing hats on their heads. The game look many oh sorry, ya Allah. Astaghfirullahaladzim. They are wearing hats on their heads. The game went into overtime. Okay, I think we stop for a moment di sini ya, preposition of time. Kita stop dulu. Thank you guys for listening. And your time. We still continue with noun and pronoun, yeah. And then what's this? And then from there, okay. So kita nanti start with. Six, ya, yeah. Word order, place of time, and then 7, kita masuk ke 7 nanti. Subject and verb agreement. Oh, it's not the same. Okay, guys, thank you very much for listening. And the homework, I give extra homework nanti during another lesson, okay? So thank you for listening. And one more, if there's a mistake in my teaching or also giving information. See you guys next week. Thank you very much. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.